Hey, what's up? John Sonmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So, a duck is laughing at me. How's that? Is the client always right? I got a question about whether or not the client is always right. You've probably heard this before. People say this all the time. The customer is always right, but is the client always right? So, got this question from Michael, and he says, "Dear John, I'm a university student currently doing a web developer internship with a company. The company has asked me to develop their website and has given me a design. The problem is the design is horrible," all capitals there. "I wish I could show you, but I can't as I don't want to get into trouble." Okay, I'll take your word for it. "I have tried to show my skills demonstrating very attractive design and incorporating animation into the website as I just can't create something ugly." Hold on, did you say incorporating animations to the website? We might have to talk about that. "But this was quickly shut down by my boss, which really upset me. This website would have been really good to put on my portfolio, but as it's so ugly, I don't really want to. My question to you is, do I have to assume that the client is always right? Should I just do exactly," in capitals again, "what I am told and shut up? Thanks, Michael." So, a couple of questions in here, a couple of things to address here. Before I address the idea of whether that the client's always right, we need to address the question of, are you right, Michael? You just started out in this field. You're in an internship. The thing about, again, I'm not saying you're wrong. I haven't seen the design. Maybe your design is better. But the thing about ignorance is you can't know that you're ignorant. That's the whole problem with ignorance, is you can't know what you don't know. And so it's possible. So you should always entertain in your mind the possibility that your understanding of something is incorrect, and that someone who has more experience or more success in an area may be correct. It doesn't mean they are. It doesn't mean that you just, you know, take anyone who wrote a book as the word on that subject, or someone who has more experience or authority as knowing more. But you should consider that. Now, you mentioned using animations, and again, I can't judge. I definitely have no design skills at all. But, you know, I know enough web designers to say that if they heard someone talk about using animations in a design, that they would probably think that that was a bad design. So, again, not trying to judge your particular skills. I haven't seen any of it. I'm just saying, I just want to preface this by saying that it's better to take a slightly more humble approach and not just assume that you have a better design and that their design is horrible. It may be horrible. It totally may be. Your design may be wonderful, but if you come with that assumption, first of all, you're not going to be teachable if it is not true. And second of all, your attitude and your approach, the way that you talk to your boss and your client in that case, it's not going to be good, right? You're going to come off the wrong way. You're not going to be able to communicate your point. You're not going to be able to give them a better design and explain to them why. So, you know, I think it's important to start with that. Now let's talk about, you know, the idea is the client always right? And how could you influence or change that? So if someone's paying you to do something, ultimately what you've got to decide as soon as someone is going to pay you to do something is you got to decide, am I going to accept the money and do what they tell me to do ultimately? Or am I not going to work with this person? And you should define that up front, right? So, you know, if someone is paying me to do something that I don't feel comfortable doing, I'm just not going to do it, right? But I need to define that up front. So you talk with them and you say, okay, well, you know, you're hiring me for this position. If I totally disagree with the direction that you're going, you know, how much input am I going to have? You got to understand that, right? And ultimately, you got to make a decision that says, you know, if you're going to actually take the money, then ultimately you've got to do what they're paying you to do, whether you like it or not. If you don't want to take the money, that's totally fine. You can say, no, I will not be part of this. That's fine. But you got to make that choice and you got to make that clear up front. And that doesn't mean that you shouldn't try to influence the situation, right? As a professional, a software developer or designer or whatever, any kind of professional, you want to say, look, you know, if you do this, this will be bad. This is not good. This is not good design. This is my professional opinion about it. I highly recommend that you don't do it. You know, I'm giving you what you should say in a very brief format, but you should do it in a much more tactful way, in a much better better way. And you give them the sort of guidelines. You give them from your personal experience. It's important that you do that. And then ultimately you say, but it's your decision. As long as it's not a moralistic type of thing where you're absolutely just won't cross this line. They're not asking you to do something like cut off a patient's leg that doesn't need an amputation or something like that. Then you're ultimately going to do it. You can say, look, I've given you what I've thought about it. I feel, I've had people come over to my house and they said, well, they're designing something or doing some kind of work. And they're like, well, this is what I recommend. Like, ultimately, you can do this if you want to do it this way. It's not going to look good, I'm telling you, but I'll do it if you really want me to. But you're going to have to sign this thing that says that you acknowledge that this is going to look like junk. Right, or whatever it is, and they'll do it, right? That's a professional, but that's the kind of attitude that you got to have, right? I think that's important, and I'll say this about that, which is that ultimately you've got to make that decision ahead of time, let's look at an example from history. So there's more than one way to skin a cat, right? So I think it was Michelangelo, right? He was, I forget the exact story, but he was working on this sculpture, and I forget who commissioned him for it. I'm great at telling stories when I can't remember anything, but anyway, so I remember the story. The dude that commissioned him to do this statue, he said, oh, the nose looks a little bit too big. So Michelangelo grabbed some, he got the ladder, he grabbed a little bit of dust, from the sculpture, and he went up to and he pretended like he was chiseling the nose, and he let a little bit of dust fall from his hand, and he said, okay, how about now? And then the guy said, oh, it looks great now. That was a great adjustment. And he didn't he didn't change anything. He had him stand a little closer is what he did, and he changed the perspective. So can you do that? If you're trying to influence someone with your design, and you know it's better, and you know that theirs is bad, can you go and can you make a change? Can you get them involved in the process? Can you say, ask some smart questions? Can you show them, can you lead them to your design? Can you show them your design? And when they say, oh no, we don't like that, this is messed up, can you say, well, what would get them involved in the process so that it's part their design, right? There's always egos involved. And if you can take that out of the equation, you're going to have much more power to influence. So we can talk about a lot of different ways to go with the subject. But anyway, I think that's about enough for now. If you've got a question for me, you can email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com. And if you like this video, I have a request for you, which is to click that subscribe button below. If you've already subscribed, you don't need to subscribe again, but you can click the thumbs up if you like this video. I would definitely appreciate that. And if you want to share the video with someone who maybe could use this advice, that's always appreciated as well. I'll talk to you next time. Take care.